Hey guys, how's it going? I'm back again with another video for you guys today. Today, as you can see by the title, it's finally here again. Once again, it's WrestleMania 30 this year, obviously. And I can't believe, like I say, every year it came so fast. I say that every year pretty much, but it's true. It did come very fast, and can't believe it's already here. I can't wait for the weekend, which I'm leaving tomorrow or early or later today if I get this up Thursday morning or so, whenever it gets up. But I'm here to give you my WWE WrestleMania 30 pay-per-view predictions, my thoughts on the card and all that good stuff. So sit back and enjoy. So we have 8 matches on the card, 7 on the actual cards, 1 on the pre-show. Let me just run down these and then I'll get more in depth with the video later. So the kickoff match is the WWE Tag Team Championship Fatal 4-Way match. The Usos versus the Real Americans versus Rob Axel versus Los Matadores. Now I think that's kind of bull because they had it on the card, like on the normal card, for like at least like a week or two. So it's kind of bull that they made it on the pre-show now. So that kind of sucks. But you know, it should still be a really good match. Looking forward to it. The next match we got is the Shield taking on Kane and the New Age Outlaws. This match, it should be actually pretty fun. I'm like the only one that's really interested in this match, but I think it could be a very solid match, so I'm looking forward to that. We got the Andre the Giant Memorial Battle Royal, 30-man Battle Royal over the top rope. I'm not going to list all them guys' names, but you know, it should be an alright match, and seeing a Battle Royal live in person should be really cool, so I can't wait for that. Then we have the Vicky Guerrero Divas Championship Invitational. I'm not going to list all the Divas out in, too, so but that's just going to be a very bad match. Next up we got is a feud that I absolutely love. It's John Cena versus Bray Wyatt. These two have just like played mind games with each other, and it's just been amazing. The promos, the song in the promo fits this perfectly, and it's just an awesome feud. So I have to give props to WWE, because 2 months ago I was like, when I heard the rumors about this, that it was going to happen at WrestleMania, I was like, there's no way that they're going to do John Cena versus Bray Wyatt. And when I saw that they did, I was like, oh crap, they're actually going with this. So, I don't know, but they turned it into a great feud, and I have to give props to WWE for doing this, and making an amazing feud, and one of the best matches that's going to be on WrestleMania. This could actually steal the show, so very good job by WWE creative there. The Undertaker versus Brock Lesnar. Now this is, on the other flip side, is a feud that hasn't been built up great. Brock Lesnar just looked like the wimp to The Undertaker. You want to have that feeling that Brock Lesnar actually could break the streak. And in this case, it doesn't look like Brock Lesnar can beat the streak, except for this past Monday on Raw, where Brock Lesnar pretty much, he did F5 Undertaker. So, you know, it's like, I mean, you can sort of see that Brock Lesnar is going in strong, but the rest of the build, he hasn't done anything. To, you know, so it's been a lackluster build, but you know, it should still be a very good match. Even though the feud's been bad, I'm still looking forward to this match. So can't wait for that. The next match we got is Daniel Bryan versus Triple H. The winner gets into the WWE Championship main event, WWE World Heavyweight Championship, I should actually say, main event. This match and this feud has been absolutely amazing as well. Just everything Daniel Bryan's contribution, Triple H's contribution, Stephanie McMahon's contribution to this feud just made an amazing feud, and can't wait for it. Cannot wait for it. And then the WWE World Heavyweight title match, Randy Orton versus Batista versus the winner of Triple H and, I was just about to say Randy Orton, I meant Daniel Bryan. This also should be an amazing match. I was getting too caught up in just Daniel Bryan versus Triple H. This match isn't going to be the best, but just the moment that's going to come out of it, if Daniel Bryan wins this match, it's going to be awesome. So I cannot wait for WrestleMania, guys. I think I should stop talking, and I hope you guys enjoy the predictions.
Alrighty, guys, so we got the pre-show match, WWE Tag Team Championship Fatal 4-Way match, the Usos versus the Real Americans versus Rob Axel versus Los Matadores. Now, like I said previously, this match kind of, like, it makes me mad that they put it on the pre-show, because they've had it on there for like a week or so. So now just turning it now, it kind of makes me a little upset. But you know, what are you gonna do? But it does suck that they had to push the Usos and the Real Americans off the main card, because they deserve to be on the main card. I mean, and I think anyone can agree with me on that. But Ryback's on Los Matadores. I could really care less. You know what I'm saying? But it should be a very fun pre-show match. It should be very fun. You know, you got the Real Americans and the Usos in there, so you know it's going to be a great match. And you got Curtis Axel, who can work all right in the ring. So can't wait for that match, and it's going to get us riled up for WrestleMania. So can't wait to see that match. Next match we got is The Shield taking on Kane and the New Age Outlaws. Now this match, it kind of disappoints me that it's happening, but at the same time, I'm looking forward to it. I'm actually excited for this match, but you know, it can go either way. But like everyone was expecting The Shield to break up, even I was, and that would have been an awesome match to have. But sadly they didn't, and I understand why, because they already had a triple threat match on the show, and having two triple threat matches, you never know. But so I'm glad that they did this, but I was still expecting The Shield to break up. But you know, it's still going to be a great match. Maybe the Shield will break up after that and lead into an Extreme Rules. So you never know with the WWE, they could pull some tricks out of their butt. But as for this match, I guess you get it going either way. Like this is like the match that I'm like really stuck on like picking. But you know, I think I'm going to give this one to the Shield. I think the Shield deserve it. And what would be the point if Kane and the New Age Outlaws won? The only point would serve is if like the like if they really want to get like a real big heel turn. Well, I mean, Dean Ambrose is already heel, but I mean, if they really want to get a big heel turn on Dean Ambrose and Seth Rollins. But the Shield can still break up even if they get the win. I don't know how they would do that, but I think they could pull that off. So I'm going to stick towards the Shield to win this match. And it should be a very fun match with the Billy Gunn in there and Seth Rollins. So it should be a very fun collision, and Kane and Roman going at it. So I can't wait for that match. Next match we got is the Vicky Guerrero's Divas Invitational match. Now, this is going to be a lot, oh man, I don't even know how to explain it. It's just going to be so bad. But hopefully we get a new Divas champion, but at the same time, I don't want to really see a new Divas champion, because I think AJ deserves to have that championship. So there's two winners that I have in mind. It's either AJ or Nikki Bella. Actually, I have three. AJ, Nikki Bella, or Natalya. Natalya deserves this a lot. She's probably like one of the best female workers in the ring, and she deserves it as much as anyone does. So if I had to choose, I'm just going to stick on the safe side and say AJ retains her Divas Championship. Next match, you guys, Daniel Bryan versus Triple H. And now, you guys, I can't even explain how much I love this feud. This feud has been amazing. just everything that they've been doing, Daniel Bryan brawling with Triple H this past week on Raw, that was amazing. The Occupy Raw, that was just insane. And this match is going to be amazing. Stipulation or not, yeah, I don't care. It's going to be incredible. But as for the winner, the person who I see moving on to the main event to be in a triple threat match with Randy Orton and Batista is Daniel Bryan. so the next match we got is John Cena versus Bray Wyatt. And again, this feud has been solid. It has been incredible. Just like the mind games that, Cena and Wyatt have been pulling on each other have just been amazing. So I'm looking forward to this match, probably second to most on this card. So I cannot wait for it, guys. You don't understand. I am that excited for it. Who I see as the winner, you got to go with Bray Wyatt on this one. Bray Wyatt easily. They just have to have Bray Wyatt. If they want to make Bray Wyatt a future star, have Bray Wyatt win here. So I'm going to go with Bray Wyatt to defeat John Cena at WrestleMania 30. Next match we got is The Phenom versus The Beast, The Undertaker versus Brock Lesnar. And like I said in the previous video, or little mini video, this feud has been not the best, but this match will be one of the best. God, I can never talk, and I suck at these, but I know that you guys enjoyed them. So anyways, The Undertaker versus Brock Lesnar should be one hell of a match, but the streak isn't ending, guys. I'm sorry to tell you that, but the streak will not come to an end. The Undertaker will go 22-0. He's lived his whole life for this 22-0. Why would they break it with someone like Brock Lesnar? it wouldn't make no sense, but Undertaker will keep his WrestleMania streak intact, go 22-0 at WrestleMania 30 on the grandest stage of them all. So, the next match we got is the Andre the Giant 30-man over-the-top Memorial Battle Royal. I only have one winner in mind, and that's Big Show. WWE World Heavyweight Championship match, Randy Orton vs. Batista versus, if Daniel Bryan wins, Daniel Bryan or Triple H, whatever the case may be. This match shouldn't be that good, but just like the moment that comes out of it, whoever, like if Daniel Bryan wins, that's just going to be an incredible moment, so that's going to be awesome to see. But as for the winner, I do indeed see Daniel Bryan picking up the win with 70,000, 80,000 for that matter, chanting yes inside the Superdome. It's just going to be one hell of a sight to see. So I cannot wait for Sunday and to see Daniel Bryan become our new WWE World Heavyweight Champion. So that's been it, guys. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I cannot wait for Sunday. You don't understand. And it's just going to be a very, very fun weekend in general. Leaving tomorrow or whenever I get this video up, like I said before. Leave your guys' predictions in the comment section below. Do all that stuff. Do all your good stuff. Keep up the awesome support. And until next time, guys, remember to follow me on Twitter, DeshaunX10. Rate, comment, subscribe. Enjoy the show, guys, and I'll see you guys when I get back from New Orleans.